us have like off bye week. Yeah, so Corey's coming back. I'm excited to see him. And yeah, you know, I'm staying in touch with all those guys, you know, because that's, you know, a big part of all of our lives. No line room was that culture that was set last year.
How much does that culture and that camaraderie that you talked about, how much does that help in a situation like Saturday where you're in a hostile environment? How much does that come into play when you guys are kind of struggling to move the ball?
Definitely. You know, that culture and just the culture, like Coach Mick's culture, our weight coach, and, you know, just having that overtime fourth quarter fight where, you know, we'll do stuff here when it's like fourth quarter program where at the end of the workout you're blown out and you got to do something like even harder that you've done, you know, throughout the whole workout, and just training you, you know, to respond in tough situations like that, you know. So that's a credit, you know, how we train the off season. You know, the off season is what we train, that's what we train for, stuff like that.
How do you know when young players learn from a close call rather than they just figure, hey, we won the game, what the heck, let's move on to the next game?
Learn from a close call, what do you mean?
Well, I mean the fact that you learn something from the lessons that might have been given by Penn State under the lights.
Right.
Tough game.
Right.
Good opponent, good game plan. Mm-hmm. You're in a hard, facing some adversity.
Right.
How do you know that your younger teammates really glean something from that?
Well, you just gotta, you know, hope they were taking mental reps, you know, watching the guys in front of them. You know, that's what I did. I always just watched the guys in front of me last year and, you know, see what they did and try to be like them because they were great players, you know. You always have someone to look up to, someone trying to follow. And that's why, you know, leaders have to set such a good example because, you know, that's, you're setting the example for the young guys. So, yeah, you just gotta, you know, watch what the older guys do and, you know, get a routine down. And just, you know, trying to be like someone who's playing good football.
Pat, I know that you addressed JT earlier, but the fact that he's a first-year guy doing the thing, not just putting up the numbers, but leading the way he's led,
right,
the whole package. And you know what it takes to play the quarterback position, all the responsibility. What would you want to say about just the job he's done this year?
Oh, incredible. You know, just from being, was he a redshirt freshman and, like, taking over that role of, you know, this university is, you know, huge responsibility, you know, Buckeye Nation, and he's done an incredible job. You know, he always, before every game, he gives, you know, a pregame speech, and I'm sure other guys have talked about it, like, incredible. You know, you don't hear anything like that from, you know, anybody else. You know, you can tell that it's coming from deep within, and he really means it, and, you know, it gives everybody a sense that, you know, this guy's got us, he's got our back, he's going to lead us. So, you know, he's one of the best leaders I've been around so far.
To the entire team.
Last question for Pat.
It's kind of just to the offense. Offensive line and, like, running backs, receiver, you know, everybody right there.
Did you sense that in him even last year when he was obviously a redshirt?
Yeah. You know, he's a great leader in the weight room, too, and stuff, and just in all the workouts we would do. But he never really had, you know, the opportunity to kind of take over, you know, everything by himself. So, yeah, now it's starting to show up more, but you knew he had it in him.
Pat, the game was almost like three different games in one. You guys dominated them up front the first half. They kind of came back and had some good plays in the second half. Then you guys were able to run the ball pretty effectively in the overtime. Just, did they make some adjustments? What were they doing maybe differently, or what was going on differently in the second half to allow them to have kind of the negative plays and the success that they were able to get?
That's it. Yep.
Just everybody had to, you know, do their job. You know, we'd have 10 guys doing their job and one guy doesn't. It's a bad play, you know. Mm-hmm. And then we had to convert on, you know, third downs, which we didn't do that well. But, no, we just got to play better overall. You know, we didn't play great.
And then the overtime, what was the success pattern there? It looks like JT simply made some good reads on when to keep the ball,
definitely,
when to hand the ball off.
And exactly. So everyone was doing their job. We were executing. We were communicating well.
Mm-hmm.
We knew what was coming. The guys were doing their jobs, and we just, you know, played like we should.
Mm-hmm.
Pat, you probably touched on this, but the look in JT Barrett's eyes, especially in overtime, can you describe it? I mean, what was he all about in overtime?
He just knew that, you know, this guy's got our back and this guy's going to lead us, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was awesome. He's a great leader. And, you know, he's a good key part of our offense, you know. Having him back there and having someone that leads like he does kind of gets everybody a comfort, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, he's an awesome leader and did an awesome job.